Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright around yon virgin mother.
Do you think he'd like this one?
Don't buy him a present.
Why not?
It'd be meaningless. You guys broke up, remember?
Yeah, but it's Christmas.
That's not what Christmas is about, Ivy.
Someone's a fountain of knowledge this morning. What is it all about, Holly?
You don't need me to tell you. Christmas is about spending time with friends and family.
And fun.
Ivy, it's not like some magic wand from Ollivander's is gonna make everything better. Wake up and smell the coffee. Chris isn't the one for you. I'm just saying, you don't need him. You don't need anyone.
I know. I can be happy being alone. You're so authentic.
I don't think you know what that means.
Anyways, I'll be seeing him at winter formal. No pressure. No pressure. As soon as he sees how good I look, he'll have to fall in love with me again.
Are they still together?
I'm not really sure. I saw him at the movies last night with Nicole. Why are you wearing that mask?
What? It's a classic.
No, it's not.
Wanna date a douchebag? I always ask, why can't you see that she keeps on clinging on to the guy that's wrong? It should be me. I always see you crying when you leave his side. I wish I could show you why. You don't wanna date a douchebag. You don't wanna date a douchebag. You don't want a dated douchebag. His own reflection's all he needs. You think that he should be the one, but he's no fun, so you should leave. Never mind his smile or his deep blue eyes. He's just not your kind of guy. You don't want a dated douchebag. Such a huge and total douchebag. Like really, really big douchebag. A massive, giant, freaking douchebag.
I don't wanna date a douchebag. Okay, bye.
That is not how I remember it.
That's not my point. Chris was a jerk. He stopped caring. So should you.
Yeah, but Christmas. Magic.
Ivy, life isn't a movie.
Party pooper. Oh, Holly, look, mistletoe.
So what?
I'm gonna keep it.
There's no helping you.
Ooh, it's so gross and sticky.
It's real. Mistletoe? It's like a parasite. It sticks onto other trees, slowly killing it.
You're such a romantic, Holly.
It is, actually. I mean, according to Norse legends. Mistletoe was born through the story of Baldur.
Baldur, the god of summer sun, saw in a dream his death. Frigga, his mother, and the goddess of beauty and love, and from whom we get the name Friday, compelled the elements, plants, and animals not to kill Baldur. But she neglected to extract the same promise from the unique mistletoe. Loki, you know, that brother of Thor, played by that weird British guy in the movies, fashioned a poison dart from mistletoe, and with the aid of Baldur's blind brother,
Hodor,
Or no, Hodor. Hodor, that was the guy, yeah.
Shot the mistletoe missile to kill Baldur. His death brought about the coming of winter. Frigga's tears over her son changed the red mistletoe berry's white and raised Baldur from the dead. From her gratitude, she blessed with a kiss that all who walked beneath mistletoe would find love. Henceforth, ensuring that the mistletoe would forever after bring love rather than death into the world.
Seriously, Cole? No more Game of Thrones for you?
I still want it!
When's the dance again?
Friday.
I think I have an idea. Women love a guy in a hat.
Because you sure as hell aren't a DJ. What? It's true. The jackass is a goddamn hack. What are you doing? You know you wanted it. You lot always do.
Get a life, Chris.
Ganging up on me now, huh? Women.
It's okay. Chris is so not worth it. He's a jerk.
Hey man, can you put this on after the next song? You okay?
Just give us a minute.
I think you left this behind.
Oh, cool. You're so sweet. I don't want it.
Of course.
Well, I'll take it.
imagination is funny. It makes a cloudy day sunny. Makes a big thing so funny. Just as I think of you. Imagination is crazy. Your whole perspective gets hazy. Start you asking.